What did you understand from this, and what is, if you have to summarize this performance in one word, what would that be? Just writing down in a paper saying that I want to go to Himalayas doesn't take you to Himalayas. It's very important that you understand this difference between outcome and output, right? Most of the time, you might be producing output, but it may not be connected to the outcome. All right. Okay, let's get going. Okay, I'm trying to quickly walk you through everyone about what is this OKR process and some of the details of the OKR process and all of that, right? So just to get you started on the basics, OKR stands for Objectives and Key Results, just in case you didn't catch it. This whole presentation, we are going to sort of use that use the term again and again. So some of you might have seen this, but I wanted to play this video a little bit.
சிறு நதிகளே நதியிடும் கரைகளே கரை தொடும் நுரைகளே நுரைகளில் இவள் முகமே.
So what is the one word that comes to your mind after listening to this, and that is also connected to our topic? You know, the underlying is what is also connected to our topic. Whatever you said till now makes sense, but what is a word that is connected to the topic?
Outcome.
Somebody has to mute. Okay, so let me not keep you guys saying. So the word that is actually connected to the topic is alignment, right? See, OKR, the entire OKR exercise is about alignment. What is meant by alignment is about, alignment is nothing but aligning all our objectives together, top down, bottom up, middle to left, left to right, all angles that is possible, right? So we use the OKR system to make sure that our goals, objectives, and are completely aligned with individual goals, are aligned with team goals, and the team goals are aligned with the company goals, right? So that's the fundamental reason why we are doing what we are doing, and this is so important when we have to march together as a single team, because we have become a very large team. Now, the bigger the team is, the alignment becomes a very, very important functionality, correct? So the reason why I picked that particular video is very interesting, right? Because what will happen, imagine what will happen if you hear people perform their part alone without the other part, how it will look. Can somebody explain that? Let's say,
Enama? Jittu-jilla parra birthday song mari irukum.
Yeah, that is one. But let imagine there are six people, right? Only one person is performing their part. How it will look? What happens to the music?
It'll sound as noise.
It'll sound as noise. Who said that?
Subhash.
Yeah, Subhash. Yeah. So that's exactly the word I was looking for. And Subhash hit it on the nail, right? All the more because he's a musical person. The alignment is the one thing that makes a difference between noise, what would look like a noise, we transform that into a music, right? If you have to, whatever we are doing, when the whole thing is aligned together, the individual pieces isolatedly might look like a noise, but when they all put together in alignment, then the noise has become amazing music to ears. Otherwise, it becomes like abaswaramnu solvangala music la. It is like somebody is a sort of doing something out of sync, right? So that is really the crux of why OKR is very, very important for us. Okay, so you need to understand this fundamental reason why we are doing this. With that background, we are going to talk about some key concepts in OKR. So there are key terminologies, right? The first, there is a terminology called objective. Second, there is a terminology called key result. Then we're going to use the word initiatives, projects, tasks, activities. This is the third terminology. And all of this together sort of mean the same thing. So they're interchangeably used. Initiatives or projects or tasks or activities sort of mean the same thing. And then there is another term called key performance index, KPI. Then there is a thing called strategy. Then there is a thing called mission, vision, ultimate goal, right? And then there is leadership team. We use the terms leadership team and management team so often, and sometimes even use it interchangeably to the extent that we don't know the difference between them. See, I sort of say this many a times, right? In the office as well. Most of the times we sort of use words like strategy and things like that very often in our vocabulary. Sometimes we don't really understand the true meaning of what they really mean. And every time that happens, every time you're using the word, any word for that matter, take a step back and understand whether you really understand the internal intrinsic meaning of those words. And to some extent, we are going to sort of do that today as well. So first, what is an objective? Okay, an objective is an unambiguous description of a goal to be achieved in the future. So that's as simple as it. It's an unambiguous description of a goal to be achieved in the future. Objective provides clear direction and motivation. If you read that objective, it should provide a direction and a motivation for anybody who's reading that so that they want to perform that objective, right? And this is like, we're going to use the journey or a travel metaphor throughout this presentation. So just bear that in mind, okay? Think of objective like a destination in a map. Like, for example, you want to go to Himalayas. That is an objective, right? Now, there is clarity, unambiguity. I want to go to Himalayas, for example, right? It provides direction because you know which way you need to head if you need to go to Himalayas, right? It provides motivation and also, you know, it answers this question, where do I want to go, right? So, of course, in the case of Himalayas, it's pretty obvious, right? But in the case of business context, it needs to sort of answer this question, where do I want to go, right? So that these are the criteria that needs to be met for a good objective, okay? Second term that we are going to, actually, we don't have to wait till the end. If you want to ask me questions, you can ask me now. So as well, if you can just interject me, you're feel free to do that. Okay. So the second one is a second term you're going to talk about is key result, right? The first thing that you need to understand is key result is a metric, okay? A metric is a sort of a number, right? And every key result actually has a starting value and a target value, which means where are you right now and where do you want to go, right? And it is the metric that measures the progress towards the objective, right? So the metric basically tells you whether you have achieved it or not, right? So if the objective is like a destination in the map, key results are like signposts with a distance marker that tell you how far you have gone in the destination. For example, if you take the Himalayas example, if you're going to Himalayas and you're driving towards north, right, and there's it basically says, you know, 1,000 miles to Delhi, because you go to Delhi and then from there you're going to go to Himalayas, let's say, right? Then it basically tells you after 2 hours, it basically says 800 miles to Delhi. Now you know you are progressing towards that objective, and that's what the metrics keeps you the check and balance. Let's say, for example, the metric says 1,200 after a few hours, instead of 800, then you know you are going in the wrong direction, right? So that's the purpose of the metric. So the first one is objective, the second one is key result. And the objective and the key results basically come together in a combo, right? You define them together. So you define the key objective and the key results together, right? So, and defining the OKR itself doesn't move the needle, okay? If you have to go from point A to point B, like for example, from Chennai, you have to go to Himalayas, just writing down in a paper saying that I want to go to Himalayas doesn't take you to Himalayas, right? So writing down the OKR itself is not an achievement, right? That itself does not get things done on its own. So what gets things done is you have to do an initiative or a project or a task or an activity. So it is not like task activities are bad things. Task, activity, project, initiatives are really the things that actually gets an objective or an OKR move from point A to point B. So this is the most important part, a task or an activity. So don't get confused. So the OKR is just a definition. It's just you're writing down somewhere and keeping it. But it is the initiative or the project or the task or the activity that help you move towards that objective, right? And that's very important to understand. So basically, an initiative or a project or a task is nothing but the work that you will do. Here is where work will happen, right? There you're defining what to do in OKR. In initiative, project, task, and activity is where you're actually performing the work, right? The work you will do to influence or impact the key result. So if your key result is going to Himalayas, which is 2,000 miles, your first step would be to go 500 miles in a day or so, right? From here to maybe go to Hyderabad or towards Vijayawada, some place like that, right? From Delhi, from Chennai. So that is really, you're trying to influence your key result, right? Progress, make progress. So basically, it is this that moves the needle for key result, right? So these are all like different approaches by which you can do. If you want to get to Himalayas, you can do multiple ways, right? You can go by walk, you can take a bike, or you can drive a car, or you can catch a flight, depending upon the money and the time and the experience that you need. Now, somebody might want a fast pace, journey towards Himalayas. Somebody want to take their own time and they don't have money as well. They want to just walk into Himalayas. Maybe they want to do it like a 2-year journey. So it depends on what is your personal aspiration as well, right? And so you can do multiple ways get to the task. When I say personal, I mean in this case companies, your team's aspiration, how fast the team wants to do. So you might want to approach or apply different techniques in your projects, because let's say, for example, you want to get to let's say 1 million visitors in 1 month, which means you might have to spend like $10 million, but you don't need to do it in 1 month. You can have 1 year, then maybe you don't have to spend $10 million. You can spend maybe like $1 million in a sustained amount of time, do some organic activities, inorganic activities, and then combine them together, and then you can get there. So you have time in your hand. So depending upon all those criteria, you pick the type of projects, initiatives that you want to do. So this is the third part. So these are the three important parts in a OKR system, right? First, there is an objective. Second, there is a key result. And third, there is an initiative, okay? So this slide will give you some idea. I'm also going to give you this deck, so you don't need to worry about it. So we will have access to this deck, and you can ask, you can refer it later. And we also are recording this, we can see it later. So now we'll go with some examples, right? So for example, you want to be a pioneer in reusable rockets like Tesla, right? One of the key results is have an engine that has a success rate of 99%, right? Which is one of the key results you want to do. A specific initiative would be design and build a new turbo pump, right? So this is for SpaceX, right? Then we can basically say become a market leader in some particular category. So you want to say, how do we know we are a market leader? We wanted to achieve a $150 billion valuation, right? So this is one way to measure. We are not questioning whether this is the right way to measure or not, but as long as there is consensus among the team, and with your boss, and with your manager, and with your leader, how you are measuring the key results, and everybody agrees, that is still fine, right? Hopefully, somebody will catch it if there is absolutely a stupid a key result, right? But mostly, when there is consensus, it's reasonably accurate. And one of the initiative is run interviews for 5 CMO candidates, and you know something like that. I'm just saying, right? But this examples does not mean if you do that one example in the initiative on the right-hand side, this whole objective will be done. No. Typically, you require a number of initiatives like 5, 10, 50, 100, depends on the kind of objective that you have to achieve the key results. And also sometimes over a sustained period of time, monthly, quarterly, half-yearly, annual, two-year projects, three-year projects. So the initiatives will also be, the number of initiatives will also be a long list, as well as the time will also be varied. So don't misunderstand just because I put one in each one of these boxes, okay? Another example, launch most popular new iPhone app, right? Get featured by Apple on the App Store. So how do we know it's a popular app? When Apple basically features your app in the App Store, you know you have achieved someplace, right? So then how do you get Apple to feature you on that? So which means you need to pass some criteria. So you need to have somebody who's working on optimization, making the app bubble up and all of that, right? I'm not going to go into these examples more. So now we got these three parts clear, which is very important. This is the crux of the system. So there is objective and key results, which always in a pair, and then there are a number of initiatives that you do to make sure your OKR is progressing. That's as simple as that. You need to internalize. Okay. Then what is a strategy? We are going to talk about strategy a little bit so that later we're going to use that. Strategy is a long-term plan to achieve your mission and vision. So you can think about it like that, right? I also define strategy slightly differently, but in this case, you use it in this context. So it's a long-term plan to achieve your mission and a vision. So why we are talking about strategy is because in OKRs, there are two types of OKRs. One is called strategic OKRs, another one is called tactical OKRs, and that's why we defined what is a strategy means. Okay. So it's a long-term plan, right, to meet your vision and mission. So what's your long-term plan? These are typically 3 to 5 year plans, directional plans. It sort of tells you the destination. It doesn't probably tell you specifically linked to, you won't probably have initiatives linked to tactical OKRs. Sorry, yes, strategic OKRs. On the other hand, tactical OKRs are short-term, typically either annual or quarterly. It is not directional. Tactical OKRs are actionable, right? And it is not a destination, but it is a milestone. There is a difference between destination and a milestone. Milestone is a specific, it's a path to the destination. You're basically saying, if I have to go to Kanyakumari from Chennai, first I need to get here. You know, the first milestone is I'm going to கோ ஸ்டாப் அட் திஸ் கூடுவாஞ்சேரி சாப்பிடலாம் வாங்க என்னது அப்படின்னு ஒரு கடை இருக்குல்ல அங்கே போயிட்டு வி ஸ்டாப் அண்ட் தென் ஹாவ் பிரேக்ஃபாஸ்ட் ஆர் சம்திங் ஏர்லி இன் த மார்னிங் அண்ட் தென் ஸ்டார்ட் டிரைவிங் ஃப்ரம் தேர் அண்ட் கோ டு த 99 கிலோமீட்டர் ஷாப் விச் இஸ் நியர் திண்டிவனம் தென் மேக் த அதர் ஸ்டாப் தேர் ஸோ யூ பேசிக்கலி திஸ் ஆர் ஆல் மைல் ஸ்டோன்ஸ் ரைட் அண்ட் தென் கோ டு திருச்சி அண்ட் தென் ஃப்ரம் தேர் கோ டு மதுரை அண்ட் தென் ஜஸ்ட் கீப் கோயிங் ரைட் அண்ட் தென் அன்டில் யூ ரீச் திருநெல்வேலி சாரி கன்னியாகுமரி ஸோ தட் இஸ் ரியலி த ஈச் ஸ்டாப் தட் யூ ஆர் எய்மிங் டு ரீச் டு இஸ் லைக் அ மைல் ஸ்டோன் ஸோ தட் இஸ் வாட் த டிஃபரன்ஸ் பிட்வீன் டாக்டிக்கல் அண்ட் அண்ட் ஸ்ட்ராட்டஜிக் ஓகேஆர்ஸ் டைரக்ஷனல்னா எங்க போறோம்னு சொல்றது ஆக்ஷனபிள்னா யூ வில் ஆக்சுவலி ஒர்க் ஆன் இட் In directional, you typically don't attach initiatives or projects. So think about it like hierarchy. Under strategic OKRs, you will have multiple tactical OKRs. Under tactical OKRs, you will have initiatives and projects.
இதுலயும் actionable இருக்கும் இல்லையா strategicலயும் actionable இருக்கும்
and that is what is tactical OKRs is all about. If you do that, that will become a tactical OKR.
Okay.
Okay. So, okay. Yeah, sure. So because it's a, see, 3 to 5 year plan, right? So see, strategic OKRs are like 3 to 5 year plan. So yearly plans and quarterly plans are still tactical. Like, for example, if you look at the project management thing, we said we want to become it's a directional right you want to become the top 5 project management softwares in a specific category now that is like very directional right you can't directly you put a lot of tactical OKRs to get to that direction right get to get actionable OKRs to get to that eventual goal okay
Okay,
so there is a framework for setting tactical OKRs, right? There are 3 themes for tactical OKRs. One is called the build theme. The other one is called the improve theme. And the third one is called the innovate theme. So build theme is you are creating something that doesn't exist before. That is called the build theme. So your tactical OKR is linked to creating something, right? Building. And the other reason why you are having a tactical OKR is to improve something and the third reason why you are having a tactical OKR is to innovate something so build improve innovate these are the 3 reasons why you would have a OKR so you will actually label a tactical OKR in one of these 3 buckets okay and I think we also talked about this last time in our performance Kislow performance model session a lot of people didn't understand outcomes versus output right you need to be very it's very important that you understand this difference between outcome and output right most of the time you might be producing output but it may not be connected to the outcome and that is often times the heartburn between your manager and a typical employee because the employee thinks that he has done a hard work and he has produced some stuff right some that is like output right outcome is the simplest way to understand is if your productivity is desirable is matching with the expected outcome then it becomes there is no heartburn situation right by default we are all output oriented by nature to understand outcomes you need to ask questions and you need to get clarity right so that is very very important to understand like for example like I gave this example like learning Tamil let's say somebody wants to learn Tamil let's say some Let's say Chintan will take. Chintan now knows half Tamil, right? He doesn't speak Tamil. He wants to learn Tamil. So that is his objective, right? Now he's watching Tamil movies. He's taking Duolingo course, but he's still not able to talk to her. At the end of doing all of these things, he's still not able to talk to an auto driver in Chennai in railway station, right? So that means he has not achieved the outcome. In spite of the what do you call efforts that he has put in to watch Tamil movies, he thought watching Tamil movies or taking Duolingo course will get him to the outcome, but it does not, right? So that is very important to understand. So you need to ask the question, if doing this is going to get you to the outcome, if doing this is not going to get to the outcome, there is no point in doing that, right? And actually, this Duolingo course is actually a classic example. A lot of people join Duolingo and they think they will learn this language, but they will, after like 2-3 months, they will drop off and they will never be able to converse in that language at all, actually speaking. So to conversing in a language, you need to take a different initiative. You need to actually talk to the people who are actually speaking that language, be in touch with them, go through. It's like speaking English, right? So unless you actually do that regularly, you won't really learn that language. So that is really important to understand. So basically all I'm trying to say is you need to watch out on the work that you are doing and ask the question, is this work helping me get to the outcome that the team wants? And the team needs to ask the question, is these things that I'm doing at the team level, is this the outcome that the company wants? If these two things are right, then the alignment happens like the a cappella music. Otherwise, it will be a noise. Right? Now, the next concept, key performance index. Right? So this is a little tough one to understand, but you will probably hopefully get it over time. Let's say we are driving towards Kanyakumari, right? And in a car, let's say, assuming we are having a car, and car has a dashboard. And what does the dashboard tell you? The dashboard tells you the health of the car. Showing the health of the car itself does not move the car from point A to point B. Just allow this particular phrase to sink in your mind, right? Showing the health of the car in the dashboard itself does not move the car. Like the dashboard, you can say all the tires, air is in good condition. That is what it will say. Battery is in good condition. It will say that. Radiator is in good condition. It will say that. You have full fuel tank. It will say that. Engine status check. It will say that. Oil is incorrect. All that, it will say yes, green, 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 right? But just because all of those items are green in the dashboard of your car, is the car automatically going to go from Chennai to Kanyakumari? The answer is no, right? So that is very important to understand. KPIs are, it's mostly ratios. Typically, KPIs are ratios in your team. Which is a measure of how your team is performing or how an individual is performing. It's a measure of performance, right? It's a health. It's a health of the system. And that is important to understand. And it is not necessarily a progress, right? So you need to understand the difference between progress and health. KPIs are health. And progress is different and KPIs are different. So I think it's a very important concept to understand. I'll use another example. Let's say you want to build muscle, right? Let's say we have somebody like Vaishnavi who's so lean and she wants to put on some weight, or Muthu Ponmari. Yunga rendu peru vandu, I want to put some 10, 20 kilos weight and decide pandranga. Let's say, or somebody wants to do body build. Right? So eat a lot of protein, which means they are growing. So that is the literal metaphor of growth, right? Literally growing from 50 kilos to 80 kilos. They want to grow. So they're eating a lot of protein, they're eating carbs, they're eating fat and everything. Now, what does it do to their system? Suddenly their system is processing all of these high food a lot of food. Now, the liver is doing overwork. The stomach is doing overwork. Your whole system is doing overwork. And people might get your damage your organs. Now, what do you do? You perform what is called as a constant health check. You check your liver, you check your blood pressure, your diabetic level, everything, and keep when you're building your body, you are also measuring all your health parameters. So your body is growing, but you want to grow without hurting your body, your organs. That is same thing applies to a team or a company. You want to grow, right? But you don't want to burn out your employees. You don't want to do certain things, right? It's not just a soft aspect. It's like you want to even hard aspects. For example, you're suddenly growing. You generated 100 leads. Previously, when you're generating 100 leads, let's say you close 20 deals, right? Which means you're closing at 20%. Now, suddenly you grew from 100 leads to 1,000 leads, but you are only closing 50 accounts. Now, the growth has happened from 100 to 1,000, which is 10 times. It looks as if the number of deals also went from 20 to 50. It also looks like increased. But actually, if you look at the ratio, you will know it has gone down to 5% instead of 20%. Ideally, it should have been, if it is 100,000 leads, we should have closed 200 instead of 50. So that is what is called as the performance indicator. So you need to grow without losing on the efficiencies, without losing on the health. That is what is the key difference you need to understand. So OKRs, typically strategic OKRs help you to, you define objectives to grow. But there are also certain times you define tactical OKRs to improve the KPI. I'll come to that. Okay. So now let's come back to some examples so that I think we're talking a lot about it. So I'll probably also also take a pause here because it's a bit complex. Meaning it's not complex, but sometimes we don't understand it deeply. It's actually simple. It's pretty straightforward. People bodybuilding example is a great example you should remember. You want to grow, but you don't want to hurt your organs, right? So that is health. Health is KPI. Growth is like growing from 50 kilos to 80 kilos or 70 kilos, okay? Yeah, any questions here? Let me pause. No? Am I still alive? Live?
Yes, Ashok.
Yeah.
It's clear.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So now let's look at some examples of KPIs. Like for example, profit, customer NPS, employee NPS. Actually, revenue share should have been written as revenue share, okay, or profit margin, something like that. So it'll always be ratios. So for example, if you look at team level examples, it should be trial to customer conversion. Support team, if it is in sales, a good example for KPI is trial to customer conversion ratio. Support team is first response times. Customer success team is days to go live, right? Marketing means visitor to sign up ratio. Product means feature velocity. The how speed, how much feature you're developing in that. So these are all like KPI examples so that you can internalize them, right? I'll just give you an example. Let's say so that you can understand it. Let's say product is doing a feature velocity of 10 features a month, right? Let's just take that. Now we had 20 people. They were doing 10 features a month. Now we added 30 more people. Now the team has grown, right? From 20, we have gone to 50. Now, if you look at feature velocity, it will also tell if the team is actually performing at certain, the health of the team is in good state, so that the feature velocity is not depleted, right? It's not messed up. So when you grow a team or when you grow any metric, like for example, visitors in marketing. So here it is feature velocity. It's to do with internal team productivity. But here, if you look at marketing, it's not to do with internal team productivity. Like marketing is running a campaign, acquiring visitors. Now we had 1 million visitors and we had, let's say, 10% sign up ratio. But suddenly we went from 1 million visitors to 10 million visitors, but our sign up ratio went to 3%. And what's the point? Right? That means that growth is not producing healthy, good healthy system, right? So you need to grow with proper healthy system. So that's really very important. And that's really what we're talking about here. So framework for setting KPIs, right? So how do you set up KPI means first you take a team and then you ask them what is their key area of responsibility, right? For example, if it is marketing, you can say lead acquisition. Now, then you can say what is the best way to measure if the lead acquisition is correct. So you can say MQL, marketing qualified lead, right? How do you calculate the current value? You basically say blah, 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 some logic, right? And then what is the target and what is the threshold value? So if you do that, then you will pretty much design the KPIs, set the KPI for a particular team. And typically a team will have a number of performance indexes, but KPIs will not be more than five. You'll probably have just five or so KPIs. With that, we'll be able to tell. Now, this is an important slide. You need to understand this, right? Strategic OKR, tactical OKRs, and KPIs, and how all of these things are connected, right? So a strategic OKR, as we said, it is a long-term plan. It's a 3 to 5 year plan. It is more directional in nature. Tactical OKRs are more actionable in nature, which helps you to progress towards the strategic OKRs. Now, let's take the car example, right? Let's say you started from Chennai, you're driving towards Kanyakumari. When you started in Chennai, the fuel was tank is full, right? You reached Madurai and the health of the dashboard is saying the fuel is getting to empty. That, right? Or you suddenly hit a puncture, you're progressing. You have a tactical OKR, you are pushing the accelerator, you're progressing towards a strategic OKR, correct? But suddenly you hit a puncture. Now you can't push the pedal. So what would you do? You take a pit stop, park your vehicle, fix your car, or your carburetor is gone, or something is water radiator is boiled, or puncture has happened, or fuel is done. And maybe the fuel station is not on the same road. So you have to take a detour, go fix that, and then make sure the health is back, the health of the car is back in the correct shape. And then you have to go forward, right? So that is that is important to understand. So you will have, hopefully, mostly tactical OKRs are linked to improving the strategic, or rather contributing towards the strategic OKR. But in some cases, you will also have tactical OKRs, which is the whole purpose is to fix the engine or fix the team, fix the team's performance rather than actually making progress, because you might have a leaky bucket. So it means how much ever you are pouring water into the bucket is keep on leaking. So what is the point in putting more and more water on top of the bucket? So you got to take a stop pouring more water, first fix the bucket and then start pouring the water into the bucket, right? So something like that. Okay, so that is the connection between all these three things. Since I use the analogy of a leaky bucket, so always put KPIs on top of OKRs. That's very important, right? So if you have a leaky bucket, how much ever you work on progress, it's not going to happen. So, and hence you always put KPIs on top of OKRs, because you need to have proper health before you try to grow. That is very important. So KPIs are important than OKRs. Remember, KPIs keeps your engine running, and it is okay. Some teams just work on KPIs. And example, I'm not saying always, I'm just saying example, sales teams and support teams, sometimes they just work on KPIs because they are like health of the system. KPIs are more important than OKRs, right? So that is very important to understand. Now with that, we are going into this concept of ultimate goal. Okay, I'll probably take a stop here. Questions? How are we doing on time? Okay, we have 12 more minutes, but I think I will overshoot this by another 15 minutes. I think we plan for that, guys. Okay, no questions. Okay, so then there is this concept called ultimate goal. Right. For example, I gave this example of Walmart so that we can relate to it. So Walmart's ultimate goal is a combination of mission and vision. The mission is to become the world leader in retailing, right? And the mission is to buy. What is the purpose? Mission means purpose, right? Purpose is to save people money so that they can live better. That's really how they defined it, right? So in similar way, we have defining Kisflow digital workplace ultimate goal is to become the world leader in a digital workplace by helping CEOs build great companies that are effective and efficient. It's simple, it's as simple as that, right? So these need not be fancy things or like slogans. This is not, these need not be fancy or sloganish. This needs to be clear and unambiguous in what we are trying to do. We are trying to become a leader in the digital workplace area by helping CEOs build great companies that are effective and efficient. That's really what we are trying to do. So everything we are trying to do is trying to see if we can get there, right? In some form or shape. Now, I'm trying to put all the concepts that you have learned till now together in a one single slide, okay? How they are all related. So there is first is strategy, right? Strategy is defining the ultimate goal and the strategic OKR. So typically, the ultimate goal is probably defined by the founding team, like senior leadership and stuff like that. But the strategic OKR is co-created along with everybody in the leadership team, right? So that is what is the... So if you can see here also, you understand the difference between management team and the leadership team, right? The management team is primarily concentrated on executing the strategy that is being put forth by the leadership team and is part of the strategy, right? And as part of the 3 to 5 year plan. And employees actually work with the management team to make progress towards the tactical OKRs. So the initiatives are typically done by employees along with their managers, which is linked to a tactical OKR, and multiple tactical OKRs, or each tactical OKR is like a milestone. And if you assume, let's say there are 10 milestones, and if you achieve all the 10 milestones one after another, then you'll probably end up finishing your tactical OKRs. So there is ultimate goal, strategic OKRs, tactical OKRs is all milestones. Strategic OKRs is like direction where you want to go. Tactical OKR is like a point in the direction, and then say he's exactly what I want to go. It's actionable. You work towards getting that goal. And initiatives and are the ones that you are actually tasks that are done by people who get the tactical OKR achieved. And the last two is actually execution. The first two is actually strategy. And the first two is done by leadership team. And the last two is done by the management team along with the employees. Of course, there'll be collaboration all over the place, right? So, but this one picture will tell you the full story of whatever we talked till now in perspective. I think we are done. Yes, and I think our managers are going to do another session for you, a small group, and then probably start communicating the strategic OKR, tactical OKR, LMA. All that, guys. Thank you.